Hey Ryan, how you going, mate? Good to see you. You should be racing these things as well. So just doing a bit of a warm up with a pace partner at the moment. And then see how things go. Got about 18 minutes to kick off. So I'm just trying to get the legs loosened up somewhat. They certainly are a bit fatigued after whatever it is, four rounds of racing. So this is round five, Volcano with the Volcano Climb with After Putty, I think it is called. So, whoever thought doing a climb at the end was a party is completely mistaken. Anyway, here's what it is. Hopefully, it's going okay. Races to go, this one and surf and turf or something like that, surf and sun, surf and sands, surf and something to go to finish the series off. So yeah. I guess the goal today is try and hang with the big guns in the AB front group for as long as I can till I get dropped out of that, and then just hold on best I can, do the climb with whatever power and legs I have left, and recover, and then do it all again tomorrow. jump over. So of course today, as I said, we're doing the Chasing Tour 2023, Chasing to Azure, we're up to stage 5, length is 40 k's, kilometres, elevation about 266 metres, half a k lead in, and we're in the Watopia world. So you can see by the little profile there, we do about 2 or 3 laps around the bottom, and then up we go, the volcano. So that'll be fun. Said nobody ever. And yes, that's what we're doing today. Bio, I've just been bumped up to B grade. So this is my first sort of stint in B grade. Yeah, I'm holding my own at the moment, so certainly not at the top, but not at the bottom. So I'm just sort of kicking around in there somewhere. And so it'll be fun. All right, 6 minutes. I'm just going to quickly go and get the fan running. So, well, good or bad, I don't know, we'll find out, I suppose. I've decided to go with a semi-aero setup. So, I'm going with the Venge and the Zip 858s, I think they are, which is the most aero non-disc wheels. I'm hoping they'll just let me hold with the front group for as long as I can. And then go from there. few zips. Got on a TT bike in here. That is keen. So it looks like we've got 12 in the pen so far. So top 10 would be nice. But we'll see how we go. Some people in here with some 20 minute power levels a lot higher than mine, so yeah. Might be the war of attrition. We'll see how we go. I've got no idea where any of these other people are on the leaderboard or anything like that. So just have to see what happens. Looks like A grade starting in one of the pens behind us. So that's good as they come through. Hopefully they'll start to pick us up. We've got C grade alongside, and then A and D are at the back. Really would just prefer to put my feet up at the moment. Gotta be honest. That is what it is. We'll do what we can. 30 seconds out. Then we get some sauce action going. There we go. see how many A's are in the pen, but there's not too many up the road. I think there's a couple floating in here with us, and maybe there's another one a bit further back. So as you can see, pace is not too bad. Not that I'm complaining. Quite happy. Plan here is just to sit towards the front of the group, mid to front, not do any work, be close enough to put some watts down if I have to stay in the break. cooking. My 20 minute power is already. But I'd have to let him go. Just gotta basically climb toilet back in and I think there's Roy behind me. And hope that maybe some of those other bees at the front explode. Come back. putties. I look at the watts now, and I'm banging out more watts than the group of 17 in front. However, that's their average. All right, Roy. I'm just going to back off a little bit. Pick Roy up. And then Roy and I are right. First draft. That's it, mate. my other favourite wheel set, which is the DT62s. Arguably the best all-rounder, so. One of my things I like to do is when I get the draft to kick up a taller gear, lift my cadence up a bit, sort of spin my legs out a little bit, and then when I have to drop down a gear when I'm going around, so it helps me to keep pace better with the pack. Helps me to recover that little bit better. I think you sort of, if you just push a big gear all the time, your legs start to fatigue. But if you can switch in and out of that, I think that makes a difference. So something I try to do on the time trials, things like that as well. And then like when I want to go past, put it back up a gear, swing past. Roy, but I'm looking at guys behind us. We're keeping them out at about a minute. I want to hold that. So you look at what watts they're putting out. A10's pumping out 3.6, 3.4s, which means we gotta be at least doing threes, trying to maintain that gap. And then you got Colorado in front of us. He's doing 2.2s. Guy in front of him is 2.3s. So you would think eventually, with any luck, we'll catch those two. Everyone's happy with that idea. He's watching, but Ryan, how do you do the elbow flick?
Hammer time. Bring it. Nice, nice. Right on.
Hammer time.
mate. Secret's safe with me. Yeah, I did it right the first lap and eventually got dropped. Those guys were just pulling nuts. And then was in no man's land. Roy here behind me wanted to team up, so he and I just been swapping turns, keeping the guys behind us at bay. And then just seeing if we could pick up a few in front. Roy and I, the bike looked like it on, so I'm not sure what's going on there. Yeah, the meter's going up on the mic, so I'm not sure what's happening, mate. Sure, why my sound's not working. Thanks, Paul. Thanks for letting me know. So, three of us here look like we're going to be able to work together. We pulled a bit of time on the guys behind. They were at 50. We've got about a minute. So that's looking good. Guy in front, Jay Colorado, must have found his second wind. He was closer than that. It was about 30 seconds. He's gone out to a minute. So I'm not sure whether he's sitting in with those A graders. We're just about done. Says that we got 7k to go. This hill is going to hurt in a minute. Not too fast if old Roy beats me up the hill. He's in the stiffened grade. Ideally, I'd like to be able to get over Jose in front of me. We'll see how we go. My legs are absolutely spent. Roy and I did a massive chasing. Jay's about 7 kilos lighter than I am. Day pop. to go. Well, hopefully I managed to get a in the top 10. Live results have me at 2, 4, 6, 8, 11th. But there's one group, A grader in that group. So if they get bumped out, I might sneak into 10th spot. So, let's see what happens. Fantastic effort, Roy. Thanks very much for pacing with me. Yeah, it worked really well. Managed to drop Jose at the climb. You worked with that, so cheers, buddy. Thanks, Paul, for watching. Nathan, Ryan, thanks for tuning in, guys. Always makes it better when you've got somebody that you know that's watching. You work a bit harder, I think, to try and look good, so cheers for tuning in. Oh, that last 100 meters when I went for it, I thought, oh yeah, that'll tick over pretty easy. No, it didn't. That dragged on. Oh well, I'm just gonna let this thing coast to the bottom of this hill for the free XPs, and I am done. If you like what you've seen today, hit the like and subscribe button. Feel free to put any comments about what you think I could have done better or try next time. I actually think the bike worked okay, the vent with the 858s, I think it was. I think that worked okay. And yeah. So I averaged 3.3 watts on the dot per kilo. The other guys all in the top 10 were like between 4.1, 3.3 was the lowest. So 3.5 is my absolute FTP best. So for me to be able to hold that like those guys, I'd have to be having like the perfect day. So I'm pretty happy with how it went today. Whew. Last race tomorrow in the Chasing the Azir, that's how you say it. Where are we? So go into the calendar. Should come up with a info in a sec. There it is. So we've got Turf and Surf tomorrow. Just a walk in the park of 49.3 kilometres, 392 metres of climbing. That's the last one of this series. Nathan, you might have to unmute it, mate. Everybody else can hear it bar you. And then we've got Chasing San Remo. Ah, you duffer. And then we've got chasing San Remo's single day race, near enough to 70 k's and 700 meters of climbing. So another tough ride race. And then we've got Spring Classics are after that. So it's a series that just keeps giving and giving and giving. Anyway, we'll think about the other ones later on. But that's what's on the agenda. Last one tomorrow. If you like what you saw, feel free to, as I said, like, subscribe, you'll get notified. At this time, I'm looking at doing it same time tomorrow. So if you're looking for nothing to do, or something to do, and you got nothing to do, tune in. All right, thanks for watching. Hutto out.